Jack, let's start with Greg Gianforte. Although he lost three newspaper endorsements, the response from the GOP, far more permissive. Where is the outrage in this for someone who is accused of committing a misdemeanor assault?
Well, Don, let me say this. We weren't there. We don't know everything there is to know about it. But I think that the voters of Montana have weighed out everything, and they've decided he's the guy. You know, I do want to say, I hope Simone won't get mad at me, but if I declare him the winner,
Jack, but
would that be CNN being the first to declare his victory? I don't know.
But Jack, in all seriousness, though, this is about, I mean, he was expected to win. I mean, no one will be surprised if he wins, but this is not about winning. Or my question was, where's the outrage for, where's the decency here?
You know, I think that we all know in politics these things happen. Think about 2012.
What? Oh, excuse me?
I have to interject. In politics, it does not happen that a potential congressman body slams a reporter for asking about the health care bill, which has an abysmal CBO score that is going to cost 23 million
two Democrat candidates. Two long-term Democrat candidates almost got in a fight in a debate and had to have a sheriff. It was Brad Sherman.
Wait a second, I watched that debate. It was nothing like the body slamming of a reporter. I can't believe you're apologizing for this.
I know another time on the House floor when two good friends of mine almost got in a fight.
Jack, are you condoning this? It sounds like you're condoning it.
I
don't want the viewer to go away with that.
Let me tell you, passionate people get involved in journalism. They get involved in politics. They fiercely believe in what they're fighting for. And I don't mean physically in this case, but they're out there and they're taking. Listen, I know everybody on this panel is perfect, but I've worked there. I've been in that case where you're working 15, 16 hours a day, and you're tired and you're exhausted.
Jack, it's
not
about.
Somebody slammed anybody?
Somebody comes up to you. And I'm not going to start tomorrow.
Kevin, it sounds like a game of chance.
I know journalists take this very seriously, but I mean, this is how, unfortunately,
I think everybody takes it very. No,
I think actually the journalist was very obnoxious. I don't think he should have
been body slammed. So what if he wasn't a journalist? What if he was a constituent?
Are you telling me he asked for it? Tell me that's what you're saying.
Here's what happens. I think that the nerves get on there. The journalist has to write a story, so he has to be snarky. Let's all admit, part of what journalists like to do is get under the skin of the people they're covering in hopes that they will say something outrageous, which will sell a whole lot of newspapers.
Hold on. Please stop.
Now, that doesn't mean that's your
assessment of a journalist. That's not what journalists like to do. Journalists just like to get to the bottom of and like to get to the truth of it. That's really all it is. That's your assessment of what you think journalists are like. I really want to hear from Kevin Madden.
I've been
Kevin
on the receiving end of snarky, snippy journalists. And
well,
you know what?
Because someone asks you a question that you don't like, it doesn't mean it's snarky or snippy. Go ahead, Kevin.
Congressman Jack Kingston, I worked with you up on the Hill. We both had questions from reporters that were snarky, questions that were smart, questions that were dumb, questions we agreed with, questions we disagreed with. Did you ever body slam anybody when you were working on Capitol Hill?
I never did, but I'm not a big guy.
Okay.
Let's not normalize it as if it was something that happens every day in politics. But let's don't over-dramatize it.
Don't under-dramatize it.